So, in the middle of last year, in 2015, we was all forced to keep... This wasn't all forced if he was doing the Monopoly lottery scratch card thing. This isn't all of them. I think I threw away a few of them. Because the whole point was, you scratched away the front, and if you didn't win, you put in this code here, and you had a second chance draw. And it was drawn on the 2nd of February 2016. And I can see two flaws in this. One, it's once again overuse of Hasbro just leasing out the Monopoly brand too far. You know, I like the McDonald's Monopoly. I love that. You know, I got right into the sausage and egg muffins thanks to that, because I won one. And it's somewhat fun. It's a prize that you're more likely to get, I think. And it's a prize that you most probably want as well. So was this, obviously. You had a second chance draw. There was one prize of 100,000. Then there was like 10 prizes of 5,000 and like 30 of 1,000. Anyway. So we'll kept them all. This is the closest I got with 7G. The rest of it I didn't get, because you had to match the full code. It's just bollocks, really, because I think this actually has done the lottery a disservice, because I've actually now got paper proof of how much I have wasted on the lottery. Now, every time I bought one of these scratch cards, I didn't lose. I think I won my money back a few times. I'd say about twice. And on one occasion, I won more than £2. It was either £4 or £5. Now, these were £2 each. And I've got 30 here. I think altogether I must have bought about 40. You know, because the first few I threw away. I didn't know you had to keep these. Because it says on the lottery, oh, it is advised that you keep them. Okay, well, now I've kept them, and now I've got paper proof that I have spent at least £50 on these. Since this draw, I have not bought another scratch card or a lottery ticket, because I just see the lottery now as a waste of money. I mean, it'd be nice if I'd won something, like a free scratch card even, you know what I mean? They've made all this money out of me. And I'm really disappointed, actually, because I thought I'd at least won a chance of something. And it just shows you how low the odds are of winning. Also, the game of Monopoly itself, I think, suffers from this constant leasing out of the license and the brand and whatever it's called. Because I love the game Monopoly. And now it's just showing me that I'm just a loser. And I think they should be more careful of who they lease the brand out to. So that's that. What else did I want to talk about apart from stupid lottery Monopoly? I can't remember now. I'm just really disappointed. Oh, well, thanks so much for this comment and subscribe. Did you do the lottery Monopoly scratch card thing? I don't think many people did, to be honest with you. I think it's just muggins here did. Muggins here. You know, me. I think I really should wakey-wakey-rise and shine. Like, I had a bloody chance. It was really weird, though, because when I looked at the list... Here's the list, actually. Here's a list. I hope you can see it. You probably can't. But there's, like, a huge list of winning codes. And my codes are nowhere near any of them, apart from that one. And it's, like, even the winning one, which the winning code was P4ZW7DT. None of man even have that Matrix makeup, do you know what I mean? It's completely different. So it's like, was that winning one drawn on a separate machine? You know, all the conspiracy theories starts coming out in my mind thinking, I bet no one's won this. And only on the normal lottery do they tell you when no one's claimed the prize. I think it's a lot harder to find the scratch card one, isn't it? I'd be quite interested to know if anyone won the 100,000 or the £5,000 prize, because there's no statistics. Oh well, thanks for watching anyway. Bye.